इन द नेम ऑफ अल्लाह द मोस्ट मर्सीफुल द मोस्ट बेनेफिशेंट। अस्सलाम वालेकुम डियर स्टूडेंट्स ऑफ सेकेंड ईयर ई, आई होप यू पीपल आर हैविंग अ गुड टाइम। आई एम योर टीचर साइमा तनोली विद द 19th लेक्चर फॉर सिविक्स, एंड टुडे वी विल बी कॉन्टिन्यूइंग विद चैप्टर नंबर 3, दैट इज़ द सोशल सर्विसेज इन पाकिस्तान। Open your book on page number 68. We have the topic with the title Problems in Health. Now what they will be? The importance of safeguarding the health of the people has been accepted by all civilized countries. Only a healthy person can perform his job well and efficiently. That is why better health standards are necessary for preventing diseases as well as for promoting greater economic production and development. As I have told you before that in a healthy body we have a healthy mind. Poor health and the prevalence of diseases are main causes of economic backwardness and poverty, both of the individual who suffers from a disease and of the nation as a whole. Unfortunately, in Pakistan, the standard of public health are very low. Population is facing a number of problems in health sector. There are many causes of diseases and ill health, of which some are highlighted here, and they are poverty. Now, what is poverty? Ghurbat. Pakistan is a very poor country and fall under the third world countries, though we are a developing nation right now. The standard of living of the masses in general is very low. Poverty of the people is the main reason. That is why they cannot even avail the basic health facilities, which is their basic social right. Average population of the country is unable to take advantage or enjoy the blessings of the modern day life, such as sports and games, hiking, different kinds of exercises, good and healthy food, and clean and hygienic houses, as well as environment. Congested population, that is too much of population, and crowded and dark houses give birth to harmful germs, which are the biggest reason for the increase of diseases. On the contrary, people do not possess enough income for proper medical treatment and drugs. Only planned economic development can change the prevailing situation. By raising the standard of living of the people and providing better health, public health facilities and service to them, especially when people will be having this basic facilities for health, only then they will be able to have a healthy life, though they are not that much rich, so that they can afford a doctor. Next is lack of education and ignorance. Aapki taleem ki kami aur jahalat. Lack of education and ignorance are also the main causes of the diseases. Ill health and high mortality rates in our country. Mortality rates are the death rates. The masses are ignorant of the rules of health and hygiene, of cleanliness and sanitation. But we being Muslim should go for cleanliness, क्योंकि आपको पता है सफाई निस्फ ईमान है. दे डू नॉट ट्राई टू कीप देयर हाउसेज एंड लोकेलिटीज इन विच दे लिव क्लीन एंड हेल्थी. ऑफन द डर्ट इज डम्प्ड एट द डोर्स ऑफ देयर हाउसेज और इन द स्ट्रीट्स, एंड द डर्टी वाटर लाइज इन द स्ट्रीट्स एंड मोहल्लास बिकॉज देयर इज नो अरेंजमेंट फॉर देयर रिमूवल. द रिजल्ट इज दैट द डर्टी वाटर इज पोल्यूटेड विद फ्लाइज, मॉस्किटोज एंड डिजीज स्प्रेडिंग जर्म्स एंड इंसेक्ट्स. We spread all kinds of diseases all around. If the standard of education is raised, the people then will realize the importance of cleanliness and will be able to improve their living conditions, and the standards of public health will become better. Hamara jo living standard hai usko raise karne ke liye education ho, logo mein awareness ho, so that they will be having a good clean हाइजेनिक एरियाज अराउंड दैम, क्योंकि ये हमें ख़ुद घर से करना है. अडल्ट्रेशन ऑफ फूड्स, दैट इज़ जब फूड में मिलावट की जाती है, खुराक में, खाने पीने की अशिया में अडल्ट्रेशन, मिलावट की जाती है। प्रोटीन एनर्जी मेन न्यूट्रिशन इज़ ऑल्सो अ ग्रेट प्रॉब्लम। इट इज़ मोस्ट अनफॉर्चुनेट डेट प्योर फूड सच एज आटा, मिल्क, गुड मीट, फ्रेश वेजिटेबल्स एंड फ्रूट एट्सेट्रा आर डिसअपेयरिंग फ्रॉम अवर मार्केट्स बिकॉज ऑफ सम ग्रीडी एंड प्रॉफिट हंग्री सप्लायर्स। इवन सच eatables are as chili and other spices are being adulterated with injurious material or with poor quality stuff. All this adulteration of food causes in the deficiency of protein. Protein ki kami hoti hai, carbohydrates, calcium, vitamins and minerals in the body. Absence of these basic diet elements result in so many different kinds of diseases like malnutrition and undernourishment. These are 7% of there are 7% of children who suffer from third degree malnutrition, जिसमें खुराक की कमी से, vitamins की कमी से, खुराक proper pure ना होने से, नाकस अशियाए खुर्दोनोश होने से क्या होता है कि बच्चों में malnourishment आ जाती है, जिससे उनको बहुत सारी problem हो जाते हैं। Like we have this example of iodine की डेफिशिएंसी जब बॉडी में होती है तो बच्चों की वर्किंग एबिलिटी, लर्निंग एंड प्लेइंग, ऑल दैट इज़ अफेक्टेड। सो इट इज़ अ ग्रेट सिन, बहुत बड़ा ये क्राइम है जो फूड में एडल्ट्रेशन की जाती है। देन वी हैव लैक ऑफ प्योर ड्रिंकिंग वाटर, हमारे पास साफ पानी का पानी होना, पीने का पानी बहुत ज़रूरी है। देयर आर वास्ट एरियाज इन पाकिस्तान वेयर गुड pure and sweet drinking water is not easily available. It is partly due to geographical and climatic reason, but also due to human negligence. Insani laparwahi hai. Lack of good drinking water is also a cause of ill health and diseases. The need is to arrange for the supply of good and pure drinking water in waterless and barren regions, but also in neglected and ignorant areas in cities, towns and villages. Hamari government ki responsibility hai at the same time to provide this pure water, drinking water. And in areas, some areas in Sindh, water is so much polluted that it causes many diseases like cholera and hepatitis and all that. Then we have polluted environment. Aapka jo hawa hai, wo polluted hai, प्योर नहीं है। वॉट इज़ द रीज़न बिहाइंड दैट? पोल्यूटेड एनवायरनमेंट हैज़ बिकम अ सीरियस प्रॉब्लम ऑल ओवर द वर्ल्ड। इट प्लेज अ सेंट्रल रोल इन स्प्रेडिंग द हेल्थ प्रॉब्लम्स। एवरी ईयर अ लार्ज नंबर ऑफ डेथ अकर्स ड्यू टू वेरियस अवॉइडेबल डिजीजेज लाइक कॉलरा, मलेरिया, ट्यूबरक्लोसिस एट्सेट्रा इन द कंट्री। इन पाकिस्तान मलेरिया इज़ रिस्पॉन्सिबल फॉर नियरली 1 lakh डेथ्स अ ईयर बिकॉज ऑफ डर्टी क्लाइमेट एंड मॉस्किटोज। आपको पता है मॉस्किटो गंदे पानी पे आते हैं, मच्छर जो होते हैं। ट्यूबरक्लोसिस कॉजेज नियरली 1,50,000 डेथ्स एवरी ईयर ड्यू टू अनहाइजेनिक लिविंग हैबिट्स। स्मॉल पॉक्स ऑल्सो कॉजेज सम डेथ्स इन द कंट्री। कॉलरा, इन्फ्लुएंजा एंड अदर एपिडेमिक्स ब्रेक आउट एट फ्रीक्वेंट इंटरवल्स। इंक्रीजिंग नंबर ऑफ व्हीकल्स इन सिटीज एंड now in villages as well pollute the environment and spread the diseases such as asthma, this is a breathing issue, eye diseases and skin trouble. So we can avoid these things if we avoid going to places, nearby places all the time on automobiles. We can go on foot, पैदल जा सकते हैं आप, साइकिल यूज़ कर सकते हैं। इन चाइना दे हैव गॉट सच अ लार्ज पॉपुलेशन but they avoid using these automobiles and most of the time they try to go on foot or by walking to nearby areas and by using cycle, which is more healthy for human beings rather than going to places on automobiles or these vehicles. Next is our social setup. Hamara setup kya hai rehne ka? Our own social setup is also responsible for creating health problems in the society. Many evil customs are the causes of ill health and diseases among our people. They are, for example, child marriages, bachchon ki jaldi shaadi, which mainly रिस्पॉन्सिबल फॉर द इल हेल्थ ऑफ यंग गर्ल्स मैरिड एट इमेच्योर एज. बच्चों की शादी अगर जल्दी कर दी जाए और प्रेगनेंसी कम्स अर्लियर बाय द एज ऑफ 19, इट इज़ वेरी डेंजरस. जैसे आफ्टर 40 प्रेगनेंसी इज़ डेंजरस, एट द सेम टाइम प्रेगनेंसी इज़ ऑल्सो डेंजरस एट अ टीन एज एज. पीपल डू नॉट फॉलो द रूल्स ऑफ फैमिली प्लानिंग. The second 5-year plan made provisions for initiating a nationwide family program, but still in our country it is limited to educated and cultured people. Poor people, in spite of lack of resources, do not follow the rules of family planning. Family planning centers are everywhere in Pakistan, and they should be free of cost so that population can be controlled and people who are poor, they can go there for help or assistance. Then we have drug addiction, one of the major problems in health nowadays. Drug addiction such as opium, heroin, etc. is a curse. Lanat hai bahut badi. These drugs slowly and gradually ruin the health and decrease the strength and energy of the addicts. By constant using of these drugs, one's body becomes numb. इंसान जो है ना वो बिल्कुल एक्टिव नहीं रहता और वो बिल्कुल लिथार्जिक हो जाता है. देयर पावर्स ऑफ रिजिस्टिंग डिजीजेज आर सो मच लोअर डैट दे फॉल विक्टम टू वेरियस काइंड ऑफ डिजीजेज. बॉडी की इम्यूनिटी ये चीज़ ख़त्म कर देती है. वन बिकम्स वेरी वीक एंड कैन कैच एनी काइंड ऑफ डिजीज ईजीली. इन मोस्ट ऑफ द केसेज ड्रग एडिक्शन अल्टीमेटली ब्रिंग्स एन एडिक्ट टू डेथ. और अल्टीमेटली आप देखें कि जो ड्रग एडिक्ट्स होते हैं इनकी they become so much anemic, खून की इतनी कमी हो जाती है, that they die at a very tender age. Then we have shortage of doctors and hospitals etc. One of the major problems in Pakistan, जिसकी ratio हमने last time पढ़ी भी है कि as against 1500 people we have one doctor and as against 29,000 dentistry cases we have only one dentist. We have this shortage. There is a great shortage of doctors, nurses, and shortage of hospitals and other medical facilities in country. There is in 1988 one doctor for about 2,000 person and one nurse for 6,000 persons in our country. There is only one hospital bed for 1,700 persons. Still, there are many areas and towns where medical facilities are not available. In those areas there is no hospital or even a dispensary. Poor people have to travel miles of distance to reach the hospital in the cities. It is seen many times that the patient dies in the way before reaching the hospitals. Hence there is need for even more doctors, nurses, hospitals and other medical facilities if the standard of health and efficiency is to be raised. So it is again the duty of the government to provide this medical assistance and dispensaries and first aid to people in even far-flung areas of the country. In short, poor nutrition, unsanitary conditions and insufficient medical facilities are some of the causes of ill health. Epidemics, waba jo phailti hai, and a high rate of mortality, that is high rate of death. In Pakistan, the problem of public health is serious in view of the poverty of the masses and their low hygienic standards. This is again the duty of the government to provide them free medical assistance, at least to the people in far-flung areas or to the poor people. ये हमारे लिए हमारा फ़र्ज़ बनता है कि हम लोगों को help provide करें in these areas. Unless vigorous steps are taken to deal with the problem of health, it will be impossible to ensure social and economic progress of the country. आपकी कंट्री का कभी भी इकोनॉमिक डेवलपमेंट नहीं हो सकती, ना ही सोशल, जब तक के वहाँ के लोग सेहतमंद नहीं होंगे और वो फिट नहीं होंगे काम करने के लिए. नेक्स्ट वी हैव द स्टेप्स टेकन बाय द गवर्नमेंट फॉर इम्प्रूविंग पब्लिक हेल्थ. How that can be done? A government has started several plans to improve public health, lessen the spread of diseases, prevent epidemics, and provide adequate enough medical facilities. Some of the steps taken by the government are described as we have the National Health Policy of 2001. The aim of the National Health Policy 2001 is health for all. Health for all meaning accessibility, affordability and acceptability of health services by the general public. That is accessibility, aap access de de, logon ko access de de ke unko un tak rasai ho jaye health facilities ki, jaise free eye camps lagte hain, free medical checkup hote hain aur at the same time door to door polio drops bachon ko pilaye jate hain. Affordability, that should be cheap enough, sometime it should be free of cost, and acceptability, that people should go easily to these places. In policy, health sector investments are viewed as the part of government's poverty alleviation program, and priorities accorded to primary and secondary sectors of health instead of tertiary care. It is also visualizes upgradation of curative care facilities, aisi facilities di jaye jisse bimariyon ki cure ho aur bachon ko, auraton ko, mardon ko unki bimari se nijat dilai jaye, unko healthy banaya jaye dobara se. Then we have National Institute of Health. That is, the federal government has set up National Institute of Health at Islamabad. It is to investigate epidemics, jo waba phailti hain, and other infectious diseases, and conduct research on these problems using modern techniques. Since 1983, the institute's public health division has been recognized as WHO's Regional Collaboration Center for Research and Training in Viral Diagnostics. Viral hoti hain contagious diseases jo ek se dusre ko lag sakti hain, uske liye research center bane hain. The institute provides practical facilities to MSc, MPhil and PhD students. They can also do their research work over there. The institute has also an allergy department with an allergy vaccine production unit. Jahan logon ko allergy hoti hai, sometimes they have having this flu allergy, so they can be taken care of. An environment health and a liquid nitrogen production unit. It is the only institution in the country for the treatment of different kinds of allergies by means of vaccines. Through vaccination, logon ko different allergies se, jaise logon ko flu ki allergy hoti hai aur aisi allergies hoti hai, uske liye iski treatment available hai in this institute at Islamabad. Then we have the Malaria Institute. Malaria has been one of the major health problems in Pakistan. For this, an institution was set up to undertake research work in malariology and to train health personnel in the subject. With this end in view, the central government established a Malaria Institute at Karachi in 1947. This institute has been functioning since then, and thus has undertaken research work in malariology. It is also providing advice to the province on all matters relating to malaria. Besides, these institutions are imparting training in the sanitary inspector course. Pakistan has achieved major success in its malaria control drive. The government has adopted the rollback malaria approach for the control of the diseases during 2001 and 2, and we have with this malaria dengue malaria as well, dengue fever. For this, there are certain precautions which are that one should cover water. If aapke paas baltiyon mein pani bhara hua hai, to it should be covered, jisse malaria banta hai, malaria ke ye mosquitoes ban jate hain. Pani kahin ruka hua na ho, usko wipe out kar dein, pani ko khatam kar dein. Jahan pani kahin ruk jayega, aapke porch mein, kahin gamlon mein, wahan phir khatra hai ke malaria ke mosquitoes paida hote hain aur phir malaria ho sakta hai. To these are the certain precautions. At the same time, malaria ki agar spray karte rahe hum, as against malaria spray karte rahe ghar mein aur specially apne ghar ke corners mein, to you should be free of these malarial mosquitoes. Then we have TB center. The present TB control and training center of Karachi was established in 1951 with the assistance of UNICEF, that is the United Nations चिल्ड्रन एजुकेशनल फंड एंड वर्ल्ड हेल्थ ऑर्गेनाइजेशन डेट इज़ WHO. इट हैज़ बीन प्लेइंग एन इम्पॉर्टेंट रोल इन द ट्रीटमेंट ऑफ पेशेंट्स सफरिंग फ्रॉम TB एंड इन कंट्रोलिंग द स्प्रेड ऑफ द डिजीज इन द सिटी ऑफ कराची. बिसाइड्स द मेडिकल पर्सनल आर गिवन पुअर ट्रेनिंग इन द ट्रीटमेंट प्रॉपर ट्रेनिंग इन द ट्रीटमेंट ऑफ TB थ्रू अ कोर्स ऑफ ट्रेनिंग एट द सेंटर. द सेंटर हैज़ बिकम वेरी पॉपुलर एवर सिंस इट स्टार्ट्स एंड अबाउट 2,000 पेशेंट्स अटेंड द सेंटर डेली. मलेरिया अगेन TB जो ट्यूबरक्लोसिस है दैट इज़ अ कफिंग डिजीज एंड अगेन इट इज़ इन्फेक्शियस एक से कंटेजियस है एक से दूसरे को लग सकती है. तो ये क्राउडेड एरियाज में हो जाती थी पहले और अगेन वन टाइम इट वाज अ काइंड ऑफ अ पेंडेमिक जैसे अब हमारे यहाँ करोना वायरस आया था. बट इट हैज़ बीन ट्रीटेड और इसकी ट्रीटमेंट अब हो गई है बट स्टिल प्रिकॉशंस शुड बी टेकन. देन वी हैव नेशनल एड्स प्रोग्राम अगेन अ डिजीज़ विच वाज अनकंट्रोलेबल जिसमें आपकी वाइट ब्लड सेल्स इम्यूनिटी ख़त्म हो जाती है. एड्स इज़ अ न्यू फेटल डिजीज़ इन पाकिस्तान. इट इज़ एज फेटल एज कैंसर. फेटल मीन्स डेडली. इट इज़ नाउ स्प्रेडिंग इन द कंट्री वेरी रैपिडली. द गवर्नमेंट पाकिस्तान इज फुली अवेयर ऑफ द एड्स एपिडेमिक इन द कंट्री. इट वॉज इन द 80s अल्हम्दुलिल्लाह बट नॉट एनी मोर. सिंस द फर्स्ट केस ऑफ एड्स वॉज कन्फर्म्ड इन पाकिस्तान इन जनवरी 1987 सेवरल मजर्स वर इनिशिएटेड टू प्रिवेंट एंड कंट्रोल द डिजीज. बट दीज मजर्स वर नॉट proportionate to the magnitude of the problem. But with the passage of time, it has been controlled. The government has launched a national AIDS program to fight this highly fatal disease. Under the program, 60 AIDS screening centers have been opened in government hospitals for blood screening before transfusion. Then next one is goiter control program. It is the one in which there is a swelling at the neck. The mountainous areas of Pakistan, which include NWFP, today's KPK, and northern areas, and almost we can say most part of Azad Kashmir, are highly contagious, or we can say highly sensitive, vulnerable for iodine deficiency disorders. इन एरियाज़ में आयोडीन की कमी हो जाती है, जो जैसे कि आपके सॉल्ट्स में कहा जाता है कि आयोडीन वाला सॉल्ट लें ताकि इस किस्म की कमी ना हो. द गवर्नमेंट ऑफ पाकिस्तान इज़ इम्प्लीमेंटिंग अ नेशनल प्रोग्राम ऑफ गोइटर कंट्रोल इन दीज एंडेमिक एरियाज़ इन कलेबरेशन विद द हेल्थ डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ KPK आज़ाद जम्मू एंड कश्मीर एंड नदर्न एरियाज़. अंडर दिस प्रोग्राम आयोडाइज्ड ऑयल कैप्सूल्स injections are being administered to the target population of the endemic areas. This program is required to cover a target population of 6.12 million living in these areas. Iodized salt is also being supplied extensively. UNICEF is supporting the program through logistics. UNICEF hamari help kar raha hai with its assistance. It has been checked. Next is the family planning program, that is to meet the serious situation from the increase in population with a national planning board was established in 1958 and schemes for introducing family planning in the country were accepted. Among developing countries, Pakistan and India were the first to have launched family planning or birth control as part of the national development program under their 5-year plan. As you know that China is the most populated country in the world and there they have only this permission to have one child. Pakistan is the sixth one in the ranking as being the most populated country of the world. So again there is a dire need that there should be a control over this population increase, and this can be done only through family planning program. Next, we have Drug Abuse Control Master Plan. Now, what is that? In 1999, the Cabinet approved Drug Abuse Control Master Plan for Pakistan. The plan aimed at reducing the demand of drugs through a campaign for creating general awareness. It also aimed at controlling the supply and production of narcotics. आपकी ये जो ड्रग्स होती हैं सब्सटेंस विद इन द कंट्री. इट वॉज डिसाइडेड टू रूट आउट द हीरोइन लेबॉरटरीज एंड द ओपियम पॉपी क्रॉप बाई 2000. पॉपी कल्टिवेशन सबसे ज़्यादा आपके मर्दान के एरिया में है केपीके के, तो दैट शुड बी चेक्ड. द प्लान रिजॉल्व्ड लिमिटिंग द स्मगलिंग ट्रैफिकिंग एंड डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन ऑफ नारकोटिक ड्रग्स, जो कि कस्टम्स बहुत स्ट्रिक्टली ऑब्जर्व करता है एट द एयरपोर्ट्स एंड एवरीवेयर दैट सच ट्रैफिकिंग और स्मगलिंग शुड नॉट बी डन. इट ऑल्सो स्ट्रेस द नीड टू एनहेंस इंटरनेशनल कोऑपरेशन इन काउंटर नारकोटिक एक्टिविटीज़. इसको ख़त्म करने के लिए जो भी काउंटर नारकोटिक एक्टिविटीज़ हैं उसमें एक दूसरे को असिस्ट कर रही है गवर्नमेंट और डिफरेंट एजेंसीज. सेकेंड लास्ट, वी हैव द एक्सपेंडेड प्रोग्राम ऑफ इम्यूनाइजेशन EPI. दैट इज़ इट एम्स एट प्रिवेंशन ऑफ 6 डिजीज़ बाई वैक्सीनेशन, नेमली पोलियो, न्यूनेटल टेटनस, डायफर्थिया, ट्यूबरक्लोसिस एंड मीजल्स. इसीलिए बच्चों को एट बर्थ कोशिश की जाती है कि वैक्सीनेशन इसकी की जाए, इम्यूनाइज किया जाए. द प्रोग्राम कवर्स 5.1 million चिल्ड्रन बॉर्न इन पाकिस्तान ईच ईयर. इन एडिशन 5.8 million प्रेगनेंट वेमेन आर टारगेटेड टू रिसीव 2 डोजेज ऑफ TT, दैट इज़ इन प्रेगनेंसी. पोलियो इम्यूनाइजेशन डेज आर बींग रेगुलरली ऑब्जर्व इन द कंट्री. द इम्यूनाइजेशन कवरेज ऑफ पोलियो डे इज़ अबाउट 95.7% इन विच मिलियंस ऑफ चिल्ड्रन वर इम्यूनाइज डोर टू डोर. ये सर्विस दी जाती है पोलियो की, जिसमें बच्चों को ड्रॉप्स दिए जाते हैं 5 साल की उम्र तक, एंड दैट इज़ अ मस्ट. देयर हैज़ बीन नोटेबल रिडक्शन इन पोलियो केसेस, कमिंग डाउन टू 35 फ्रॉम 119 इन 2001. Since July 2001, vaccine for hepatitis B has been introduced in EPI regime. The number of district reporting polio cases has come down to 26 in 2002. Hepatitis B ki vaccination at birth bachon ko di jati hai, start ho gayi hai, aur it goes through a different intervals, that at birth, then at 6 months, then 1 year, and like this. So it is a must फॉर द फ्यूचर जेनरेशन. हमारी फ्यूचर जेनरेशन हेल्दी होगी, फिट होगी, तो दे विल बी एबल टू होल्ड अस एंड होल्ड द नेशन एज वेल. देन वी हैव वेमेन हेल्थ प्रोजेक्ट. दैट इज़ द प्रोजेक्ट हैज़ बीन लॉन्च थ्रू आउट द कंट्री इन 2000. द प्रोजेक्ट एम्स एट इम्प्रूविंग द हेल्थ, न्यूट्रिशन एंड सोशल स्टेटस ऑफ वेमेन एंड गर्ल चिल्ड्रन बाई डिवेलपिंग वेमेन फ्रेंडली हेल्थ सिस्टम्स इन 20 districts of Pakistan. And at the same time there are many other such things, like we have taking care of the kids, bachon ki hygiene ho, unki health ko dekha jaye, unko manage kiya jaye. Civil especially child survival projects hain. In 1988 the government of Pakistan in collaboration with the USAID has launched the child survival project for a period of 6 years, that is from 1888 to 94. Its aim are to improve the quality of the life of the rural population and urban poor, and more importantly to reduce the infant and child mortality rate. Jo bachon ki death ho jati hai ek saal ke andar andar, that should be checked. So this is all for today. We have studied the problems of health and the different measures taken by the government. Revise these things, keep on learning, and thought of the day is prevention is better than cure. Thank you and have a